So you guys kind of are like led through these kind of fairly antiseptic hallways.
Two Gamorreans, one bucket.
There's a big white wall, and it has, you can see that there's like little small plaques on it, little golden plaques on this big white like marble wall. And there's a sedate looking woman standing in front of it. Her back is to you. Bob, red hair, the white robes with the silver highlights.
It's a pleasure to meet you, Bob.
The guardsman who's like escorting you guys.
Playing the guitar.
just something I noodle around with. It's his
you guys heard Smoke on the Water? It's pretty sweet.
Here we
just
go,
learned
ready?
It.
No way, I can do it. I can do it.
In high school, that's all my neighbor knew how to play, but he would practice the guitar for 3 hours a day anyway.
So
it was just the Smoke on the Water opening. Over and over.
So he's carrying his gun. It is not a guitar. It is his ceremonial gun of office.
Pretty sure it's a guitar.
Chancellor Mothma. They're here. She turns around. Yeah, it's Mon Mothma.
What happened to the weird hippo guy?
She looks a few years older.
What?
Oh, that's later.
Okay.
Yeah, that's later. That's the future.
The one who was in the episode 7 for 3 seconds was like, what's that ominous red?
Yeah, he's right, but it doesn't matter.
Okay.
So, thank you for coming. And it's former Chancellor Mothma, but thank you.
We didn't
Gringo,
say anything.
I take it, and Root the Ewok. I've seen you on the holonets.
I'm very famous now.
And very smelly. You should have showered.
Yeah, we really probably should have let you in the ship.
No keeper god!
Ah!
You remember Gippy, of course.
Hello,
I've been to.
Yes, I knew you was a child.
I thought you were dead.
Yes, the rumors of my demise have been greatly exaggerated.
Believe me, Your Highness, we tried.
Sadly. Ah, and you're a droid. Well.
Here's my slave.
Well, you know, it's not murder if a droid does it.
I'm glad.
It's true, you aren't sentient, you don't have rights.
Yes, these are my associates.
I'm glad you were able to come. I know that you were close, probably closer than anyone with the late General Jan O'Donnell.
Really? Ooh. Us?
Wow,
did you write that down or something?
That is sad.
He did. He spoke highly of you in his, video journals.
Okay.
Yes, I'm sure he did.
Did he have some sort of will, maybe? Last will and testament?
There wasn't much left that we were able to find.
I'll take what I can get.
It says, gesturing to the wall, and you can see there's all these plaques, and there's just one little, like, 2-inch plaque, 1-inch high. It just says General Chando.
Is there any of his DNA left that perhaps we could sell?
I knew we should have gone with Crix. Crix comes from money. Crix Maydeen?
The current new general of the, what's left of the military. It's been essentially disbanded at this point.
Well, he was a good man.
He spoke highly of you. He spoke highly of your compatriot Tamaya as well.
Her?
Unfortunately, she says as she turns, gesturing for you guys to follow her, me and Dodonna didn't see eye to eye on many issues.
Yeah.
Yes, of course. One of which was this extrajudicial military wing that he thought was so important. Well, it's the opinion, of course, of the entire New Republic that a military is unnecessary. It makes us more like the Empire than anything ever.
Well, that is a really stupid opinion.
None of us bought into Dodonna's delusions that they're going to build another Death Star.
Oh, boy, you are...
Highly unlikely.
You have not learned a damn thing.
Who needs a military when you have performers like this young lady here? Like, really, propaganda is the future of the New Republic, especially when it involves Rancor defecation.
And I agree that...
So is there any of the Empire left? They seem more
competent. He says, turning away from Gippy Bindu. You've been traveling. Yes, of course you have.
Not on purpose. Your message said to bring them.
Oh, I don't think
you owe me for ship damages.
Sorry, I doctored the message.
What?
I thought he was funny.
What?
Yeah, I thought he was dead.
And you owe me 3.5 million credits.
That's
I've
true.
I've heard this. Listen, my harem died, many Bothans died in the assault in order to retrieve the plan for the latest Death Star. Listen, there's a little bit of crossover there. At least you can do is wet my beak. And by beak, I mean these glorious folds.
This brings me to why I've called you here, which is, of course, that you no longer have a position within the Imperial, Imperial, the New Republic.
You're firing us?
Yes, your position's been dissolved. There's no need for you to be employed by us anymore, and I wish you the best.
So you're saying we're not on your side anymore?
You
know how much we could get if we get
no longer have a
I was one of the founding members of the Imperial Senate, and one of the most respected diplomats.
Takes out her data pad. No, not anymore. I'm editing this.
I had a sash and everything.
There's no sash.
You had a long and dignified standing within the old republic, unfortunately.
Long dignified and standing. Listen, there's your memoirs.
If this is about the orphanages, I promise, like, I only sold 3 or 4 for eel gel.
Also, the period of time in the various penitentiaries has disqualified you from public office. The new senators from DAC have been performing admirably, and I'm sure.
Do they require eel gel? That's all I'm saying. Perhaps I can bargain.
What
here.
I'm trying to express to you is you no longer have a position within the new republic. And are no better than, say, a rambling old lunatic. Who should just really, perhaps,
point,
die.
Point of order.
But perhaps a rambling old lunatic with an inordinate amount of eel gel.
Point of order, if we don't work for you and we have no relation to you, why are we here and you're still alive?
Tamaya.
If you could explain that very quickly.
My slave does have a very large phallus that is actually a chrome gun. So I would like to know the answer to this as well.
What's our girl gotten into now?
Threatening violence against former chancellor of the New Republic? In the heart of the New Republic's
power? Oh, you're the former. Where's the real one?
Ah, well.
I'm just representing the interests of my client, the star here.
No.
My turn.
No.
I see that does make sense. Some of the videos that I've seen have been rather indescribably filthy. Well, I'm the new chancellor until for the next few hours, until the formal vote finishes and the council decides on the new chancellor.
I'd like to put my name forward as the president of the New Republic.
Please
Can
roll.
Can I roll on that?
I think. Yeah.
You guys reach a door that you guys have been walking to. The door's open.
It's just an airlock. She just
pushes out. I totally get it.
I'll take you with me. It's all worth it. And you all die.
Mon Mothma, hero of the New Republic.
The end of my game forever. Going to end it on a better note. Guys, the door's open, and there's this is the data core, she says. I'll let Dodon explain himself. What it is that you need, what we need with Tamaya.
Pull out my gun.
You guys come through, so there's this command console room. I mentioned he left many video diaries, he says. She says, gesturing.
Oh, yeah, they were often explicit.
Right, drag me into this next room.
All of it. You haven't been walking under your own power. Drag the whole time.
Not in like a decade.
The amount of oil tears.
We really should get a hover sled. This is
Can we get someone to vacuum the fat out of him or something? We can get him to walk.
Seems like a good suggestion, yes. Many holo videos, which he has been sending, he sent back up until shortly before he died, per his official office. We've collected that information here, in the data cube. As you guys see through this glass window, there's this giant room. It's all very techno looking, like a big metal cylinder, and there's lights along the sides. And in the center of it,
like 22 Jump Street?
Like I have not seen 22 Jump Street.
Oh, they have a giant ice cube for Ice Cube.
That's stupid. It's probably not funny.
It's ingenious.
It's ingenious. There's a giant, it's kind of on its point, like imagine a Rubik's Cube that was scaled up to like 30 or 40 feet on each side.
Yep.
All made out of shining chromish metal.
Mm-hmm.
Many, many smaller cubes that make this thing up. Spinning slowly in space in front of you guys through this glass window, and little hover droids coming up to it with little extendo claws and grabbing it. This is, of course, the data cube, where we store all of the most important files in the New Republic.
All I can think of is Rubik's the Magic Cube.
Ooh. Oh, that's a great show.
Yes, please, if you can, please Google Rubik's the Magic Cube.
I'm so glad someone else other than me has seen Rubik's the Magic Cube.
Yes, please. Okay.
You guys remember the Alf cartoon?
Yes.
That shit was weird.
Yeah, all right. Alf's family back on the Alf planet.
Not as good as
Melmac?
Not as good as I'm Rubik. It's like someone saw E.T. and decided Rubik's, like a Rubik's Cube is a good idea. Anyway.
On paper, it's brilliant. Yeah.
It is.
What if
really
Rubik's
is.
Cubes were aliens that loved children? So this giant metal cube is rotating.
Yes. How do we kill Dodona some more?
Service droids, pull up Dodona's final records.
Service droids, erase!
And it's like,
as if there's different droids than service droids.
I can and will kill you.
No one can kill him.
We've tried yes, so hard.
You tried as well as time. Both of you will fail.
You saw what I did to that rancor.
Across.
Imagine if you lived through that.
I would love to happen. That's how I want to go out. Shitting on an Ewok.
Shitting on an Ewok.
Root looks real nervous for a minute.
Why do we even do this without Gibby Bindu ever?
Listen. Gibby's been trying to get me into shows just to reenact.
Oh no.
I keep saying no.
No, that's what we got some stunt Ewoks coming
Gibby's
in.
He's all about consent if he's about anything.
Yeah, for sure. There's definitely little people in like Wookiee costumes.
If you pay me, you can shit on my Ewok.
The Geonosians.
They just put tiny humans in
no,
the
No,
no,
it's Geonosians in Ewok costumes.
God forbid we harm any of the little people who enjoy anthropods as much as I do.
They lost their planet, so now it's...
Like,
Dodona's about to start speaking.
I thought I erased
the big,
it.
The big curving. No one listens to you.
How do I slice?
There's the big curving
I slice
like,
it.
Glass window. And so it's like a 6 or 7 foot tall window, and it stretches like in this kind of curving arc that you guys are looking out through. Is projected, overlaid with a video of Dodona. It's like if he had like the YouTube video right in his face doing his thing.
Subnation!
Yeah.
He's Phil DeFranco.
This is John Dodona coming to you with...
I love this vlog.
The Erotic Adventures of John Dodona, Volume 16.
No, says Mothma. This was a funny bit that I was going to do, but it's all
overshadowed by rancor poo.
Let me just fast forward through. Oh, that's the wrong one. That's the wrong one. Yeah. Okay, here we go.
Don't forget to like and subscribe. Look and subscribe.
This is Jan Dodona coming to you with the non-erotic adventures of Jan Dodona, Volume 3.
Boring. No.
It's going on, and he proceeds to relate the recent events right before you guys got to Fabian's roost.
I'm most concerned with Tamaya.
Is he still in disguise?
You can see that hanging up behind him. Yeah, it's just in the whatever quarters of the Hertz he was in, honestly. You recognize the own ship. You guys just came down in the quarters, which you've now desecrated, probably with fluids and excretions.
Absolutely.
We just put him in the Rancor's poop chamber.
And he starts explaining about Tamaya and everything she's done in this unusual Sith holocron and how he's worried about the course that she's gone down. But, you know, honestly, he thinks he can make it up to her and like this might be good for her ultimately. He owes her such a huge debt. Everything that he's put her through, he feels. And he also starts explaining about,
I'm worried about these symbols of despair, which seem to be cropping up around the galaxy in strange quarters. I believe they presage a pattern, a swelling, a great upswell of the dark side that I fear is threatening to break loose in the galaxy at large. I think perhaps... It's merely waiting for a spark that could throw everything we've achieved in the New Republic into complete and utter chaos. I wish to speak with my old friend, Yoda's younger brother, once we get back from this expedition to Fabian's Roost. And see if we can't speak with him. He is most knowledgeable in the ways of the Force. I have his most recent coordinates here, and we shall... be in touch with him as soon as possible.
No recording ends. Mon Mothma resumes talking. As you can see, what he's spoken to, we can't ignore. Tamaya Lek has clearly sided with the dark side. And that makes her...
Shut your goddamn mouth.
A traitor to the New Republic. All right. Everything we stand for.
I turn on my gun. I would choose your words more carefully, Mon Mothma.
Unfortunately, the restraining bolt that they would put on all droids as you came in...
They put a restraining bolt on me, they fucking die.
It's unfortunate that you're a fucking machine who's a slave, but this... You would be yes, you have a restraining bolt on you.
If you don't have a restraining
bolt, oh god, I love my flesh.
You would be back. You would be back at the docks.
Oh, then I'm gone. I'd just take the ship and leave.
Well, you wouldn't be.
Goodbye, guys.
You need to roll for that against my diplomacy. That
if you would, Drew, if you wish to exit the narrative at this point, and you have.
If they try to put a restraining bolt on me, that's the end of their lives.
Jeez.
I don't know, man.
I would definitely murder anyone who puts the bolt on me.
What if you're a sub, though? Like, what if that is like your.
PNL is not a sub.
Okay, fair enough.
PNL tops the universe.
Debatable. So.
Give me a fucking firm place to stand and a gun that's long enough.
Can I flip a destiny point to take out my remote and turn him off?
Yeah. No destiny point required. Now, here's the thing. It's pretty clear that if you tried to pull guns on the leader of the free world in the center
she's
of
the not world. Anymore. She's over. She's done. She's Hillary Clinton. She's hiking in the woods in New
my
York.
My question is to
I'm
you,
technically a lame
good
gun.
Sir, how do we make money off this situation? And more importantly, all she has to do is not talk shit about you via this situation.
Importantly, well, before okay. you answer that question, importantly, and before you think about what your next actions are, I would recommend you watch your words because you're close associates with Tamayalek, a traitor to the New Republic who needs to be hunted down and stopped. And that either makes you aiding and abetting her, in which case,
mm-hmm. yep.
you will be transported to.
I'm sorry, you'll be turned into a smoking skeleton?
To an asteroid penal colony.
Smoking skeleton. I blew up one of those before.
To serve, you know, the rest of your days at high treason. Or.
So you're saying there's no reason not to kill you right now because we're going to jail anyway.
No. I'm not going to. Too famous for jail.
It seems like he's trying to say something, but you've turned his volume down so low. Fortunately, I can't hear him yet. It's just below the level of my hearing.
Hey, what's your armor? What's
something.
Your soak value, Mon Mothma?
I'm not quite picking it up. But
soak value is. Because I got Pierce.
Alternatively, you can cooperate with us and help us hunt down your former. Comrade who has turned against everything the light side stands for. We could use your expertise. You knew her better than anyone. If you can help us track her down and bring her to justice, we'll see to it that you are treated as the heroes you are within the New Republic.
Yeah, sure. The people who've kidnapped
us,
forced us to work for them at gunpoint,
silence,
sent us to the pit.
Silence, droid.
I'll murder you too.
I have seen the Old Republic, the Empire, and the New Republic rise from the ashes. And I
it was just
say,
the regular republic. The old republic was a long time ago.
Oh, yes, regular republic. I've seen all of these factions rise and fall throughout the years, and I must say, it's always to our advantage to do whatever the person in charge says. So
we shouldn't listen to Mon Mothma because she's not in charge anymore.
No. I mean, like, technically, she probably has her best interest in heart. At least she has money.
No, she definitely doesn't have any of that.
I certainly do have your best interest at heart.
They have never paid us.
I say we do what the famous person and the person with the money says.
That's right.
I leave it up as an individual decision to all of you. Any of you who do not wish to side with justice and rightness can serve out the rest of your days in a penal colony. But those of you who do wish to help us hunt down dangerous rebel Tamayalek. Sorry, rebel is probably not the right word because I was once one. But you get what I'm saying. Feel free to side
nope,
with me.
Gonna kill Mon Mothma now is.
Go ahead, guys.
I already killed Dodonna, so that was my primary.
Can I gesture people over and whisper at them?
Of course you can. Me?
No, not you.
What is it, please? Oh, no. Oh, here, I'll stand over here.
No,
I do have a thing to check.
Here, Miss Mothma, just hold this spherical device that's beeping. It's not a thermal detonator.
Turn it off? Thank you. I don't know how you got through with
that. She's like a Mon Mothma. She's done some shit, okay?
Yeah.
Right. She didn't do shit. She put on a dress and was like, I don't know. I guess this rebellion's over.
You know how those fucking Bothans died? Yeah. She fucking killed them. Anyway.
Good luck.
Look, if we get to Tamaya first, we protect her.
All right, let's kill Mon Mothma and then let's get out of here.
No, but let's get to Tamaya first.
Right, after we kill Mon Mothma.
You don't kill the person paying you.
They're not paying us.
Yes, they are.
They've never paid us.
Listen to the Ewok.
With that windfall.
How many missions have we done? Because we went to a treasure planet and we got away with it.
Literally,
how many missions have we done for the Republic against our will?
Hit single first, and then save person second.
All right, I like this.
Payday third, then kill Mon Mothma fourth.
Outlaw country!
I'm just saying.
All right, thermal detonators on the ground.
save that until the sweet, sweet earworm weaves its way throughout the galaxy via Ewok.
All right, but our song's called Mon Mothma's a Stupid Bitch.
One word, diamond. That's all I'm saying.
Okay, that's, yeah.
Diamond!
That might have been, that was our first encounter. And we found the name of tonight's episode.
So, do I have it? I need answers from all of you.
So you're saying we say yes and we don't go to space jail, or we say no and we go to space jail or we kill you?
Partially right.
I have a question. I'm seeking recompense for the boffins made of my harem that died in the assault to claim the Death Star plans most recently. I'm just saying that I'm owed at least 3.5 million credits, which is at least half of what I owe this man here.
I agree. I don't know what he's talking about, but he probably owes me money.
Listen, I love Sabacc.
Yes. I'm sorry, I'm not sure that you will be making it. I don't know, did I say everyone had a choice about the penal colony thing? You never knew Tamayolek, did you? And in that case, you also are...
You knew Merce, though.
Guilty of countless crimes against not just humanity, but also just conscience. just the fundamental concept of being a sentient being.
And I brought him here so I get that reward.
That sounds fair.
You're next.
Our fund, whatever extremely generous reward you have in mind, straight to him, so that I may continue enjoying my boffin concubines.
Yes, so Jay, wonderful. The two of you will side with the New Republic in this case, I sense.
I'm busy next week, so I'll pass.
I'm not here next time.
Oh. That's okay.
But we'll I'll be around.
Okay, good. Well, I'm afraid that you're going to... But as long as you're siding with the New Republic.
Oh, of course, yes. I have the best interests at heart.
Little famous Ewok.
I will lead this expedition.
She's the hero here.
Good, then you two can help us.
Things have changed.
Corral this one into one of the holding pens.
I'm your god.
There's not a holding pen that can
That's the devil.
It's
true, I can't get the shackles around his fat wrist.
It's extremely awkward, I apologize.
Shock prod.
That's only making me more excited.
It's melting the tips on the shock prod.
Yeah, you might just want to find like a flat, open area and just leave them.
It's true, they can turn just off your
droids. A ranch of some sort.
Hit the droids on the head with a board and they just, he'll die here now.
Well, now you have to carry him, so that wasn't a great idea, but all right.
We'll just leave him here to die.
In this room with a bunch of electronics?
Yeah, it should take long.
I'm going to roll diplomacy to not die in this room.
Wait a minute, P9L.
Yeah.
Are you continuing to persist in your desire to kill Mon Mothma and
only she keeps being a super bitch?
Oh, I take exception at that.
I don't.
I am taking.
You just called my master evil. Oh. She's a little confused.
He needs a memory wipe.
Sure. You touch my brain, I'll kill the whole New Republic.
They all feel like that before we touch
you
their
can brain. Do that remotely, right?
I am
right?
just taking these coordinates.
You can probably do that remotely.
Hey, Huxy baby.
Don't mind this I piece found of equipment that we randomly took with us that we have cool no regard planets. For feelings.
Okay, well, this makes sense. Okay, so...
Hot redhead imperial at empire.net.
If you want to make
and send.
If you want to make a leadership or diplomacy check to try and convince them to let you go,
I'm giving,
with
I'm
this
giving,
group as opposed to be arrested immediately, that would be fine.
I'm giving General Hux the coordinates of the New Republic. So much.
I guess that's fair.
I have his email address.
I guess that's fair that I have to roll to continue.
We're in the same Babylon 5 fan club.
or not at this point. That's fine.
So what's the difficulty?
Well, you said you wanted to make a leadership check, right?
Right. Yeah.
No. Point taken. You want to side with the New Republic, though, in this case?
Absolutely. They're in power.
Okay. I do think I need some sort of... it's not a role, then just you make a case. Why would I not just... have you arrested immediately?
Do you remember?
Because he was an Imperial criminal.
Do you remember the Battle of Endor? Do you remember that? Just maybe off the top of your head.
Yes, I remember the Battle of Endor.
Do you remember the giant ships? They looked kind of like this. They had the Dak cruisers. The Dark Cruisers that were at one time luxury ships that people cruise across the galaxy to enjoy themselves in pleasure.
I'm not playing that old.
Oh, shit!
Those wouldn't even exist if it weren't for me. You. Akbar was a fucking tadpole when I was busy spreading my seed across the galaxy. If it weren't for me...
Progenitor of the Mon Cal race.
If it weren't for me, you wouldn't even know it was a trap. So bring it.
All right. No.
Fair enough. I guess I'm grandfathered into this new Republic.
That's a fair point. Okay. Mm-hmm, I see that you still have your wits about you to some degree.
Yes, I need to sleep now deeply.
Very well. I will designate... him as the supervisor.
At least a week, please.
No.
Nope, too late. It happened.
Not.
I claim the Ewoks, but
all four of you will be answerable.
No. My tiny little Ewok men. It's just that I constructed myself out of sticks and a piece of canvas.
Yes.
Snaps immediately.
Enjoy the co-pilot seat for those sweet dreams.
That's what you call your back and scrotum.
All three of you will be answerable, of course, to Sergeant Jonst here.
Jonst.
I knew a Jonst 80 years ago.
Jonst!
It's close enough.
I knew a Jonst 80 years ago. Jonst. What a fox she was.
Says this is one of the blue looking guys slides up his face.
Ah!
Of his helmet.
I wasn't expecting it.
Of his helmet, square jawed, blue eyed guy.
Freakish, but continue.
And he's voiced by. I hesitate to roll. Did you, Barney the dinosaur?
I love you.
You love me.
Oh God!
I kill puppies on TV.
Hi kids.
Hi kids.
Ooh, you knew my mom?
There you go.
Biblically,
80 years ago.
We called her BJ.
I sure did.
Terrible. By the way, those suggestions, I don't think we called her BJ. That's by Shadow Taxes. Thank you, at Shadow Taxes.
My favorite kind of taxes.
James Earl Jones was at Andy Heathcote. Thank you, Andy Heathcote. And was that it? That's all we had, right?
Do we want to roll again?
For what his voice really is?
I don't think that's a good one? I'm appreciative of Barney the
Dinosaur. It's a little silly. I mean, if we rolled again, it would be Paul Lind.
Oh my God, crocodiles!
Mon Mothma, what are you wearing?
You want an Indian rattle?
That's who. So it's Paul Lind underneath the face mask.
Oh, I'm in charge. This will be great.
Just as surely as Paul Lind was gay.
Captain Jonst. Great, is in charge, is in direct oversight, and will be reporting you guys back. And if any of you, of course, transgress against this agreement we have, Captain Johnston would be in charge of punishment.
It's a
and
shame
reporting.
He died in battle.
Yeah, I clearly see him flying in an accident, in an unfortunate accident.
Are you proposing treason?
I am not.
No.
Root is not saying that.
No.
He
was cleaning the airlock.
All I'm saying, if you're implying that about her, then you really need to talk to a publicist, because it's not going to turn out well for you.
Yeah, but Captain Johnston is fairly confident that he can handle all this, right? Mm-hmm.
Well, nice to meet you, Captain Johnston.
Someone's voicing him, not me.
No, it's fabulous to meet you. That's simply a thrill.
Gregor's the name.
Oh, that's ridiculous.
All right, but it's my name, so, you know, respect it.
No! I'm only kidding. You know me.
He's very mean.
I was a center square, probably.
He's very loud.
Captain Jesses.
Why are you more Harvey Firestone?
I don't know.
That Harvey
oh, my
I
God.
Don't know.
David.
I've got to call my mother David.
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 Why is it only quotes
Because it's the only movie that ever mattered.
So, the two of you.
Ah, forget my therapist.
Matchmaker, there.
That's right, I run a cable television network, or maybe just a company. It's unclear.
Those other two.
But we don't care about recycling.
Poland's two backup guards.
Yes.
Are both voiced by Harvey Firestein. Stein?
Honey.
Firestein, I think.
Okay. Yeah, so those are the other two.
Harvey Fire Island.
Lower ranking, they don't have the big Imperial crest. But Poland and the two Harvey Firesteins proceed to lead you guys back towards the Hertz, where they will come back.
Oh, we've got to get on this ship.
Actually, they're going to escort. First thing that Poland and the Harvey Firesteins are going to do. That's a band. Is escort, with your help, escort P9L to the prison ship.
You want to come with me, Harvey?
No, you don't want to do that. He's back on
commission.
No, you want him back on the ship without his restraining bolt. You don't want to try to put him in jail. Yeah,
I'd take you escorting me anyway.
Well, in that case, we're going to need a real initiative.
So Mon Mothma is like,
I have to go to the bathroom.
Well, thank you for informing me. I hope you can hold it.
I've just been going this whole time. Like, what?
What's Mon Mothma's smoke? Is there soap damage?
There's a room for that.
Captain Jones, escort him to the thing. I have to study more of the private files. I think we can find if Dodonna was in touch with Yoda's younger brother. Well, that's not for you to be concerned about. That's for me.
Also, I'm the only one who knows the person you're looking for.
She goes over to the big dials and starts dialing them and going through the footage. You guys are escorted out by Captain Johnston, the two Harvey Firesteins.
As we leave, we see the last video is Giant Dodonna taking off his shirt.
That for sure is happening.
The new erotic adventures of General
Giant Dodonna.
Good riddance.
Volume 16, Part 2.
No, what?
So you guys are escorted into the hallway. Okay, how are we doing on time? We got much longer before we got to wrap it up.
I love all these deleted scenes from Rogue One. They're really great. That's all I'm saying.
Now, if they're deleted scenes from Rogue One, I would have CG Princess Leia walking in behind the background.
Oh, dear.
The whole time.
Did you see her urn today? Was a jar of Prozac?
So fucking good. God damn it. She's amazing.
Yeah. She is. She was amazing. And now we have her computer-generated form to watch on TV.
Stop. Fucking stop. Anyway.
I could jerk it to it.
Ooh.
It's real enough.
No.
I have to edit all
Even
this
I
out.
Have limits, my friend.
I just want to find them. That's all.
Okay.
It's all right.
Special night.
I watched recently her wishful drinking special.
It's so good.
Which
thanks.
I highly recommend. It's
thanks
on
for
HBO.
Tuning in.
And,
tell me the odds.
Basically, she said, she's like, I'm so grateful there's a Leia sex doll, so whenever anyone tells me to go fuck myself,
I
can.
Mm-hmm.
We had a wonderful
what
time here tonight.
I'm pretty sure I did die in that last adventure.
I'm pretty sure I did die
in that pit.
Yeah.
Okay, so since
so who's going to try to make P&L do something he doesn't want to? Because that's not going to end well
for
them.
The three of you, Paul, and
it's
going to
be me,
Firesteins.
And it's going to involve a lot of hugs.
I can run away from your two droids.
So you guys are, there's a moment after you guys are escorted out where the hallways are empty, and it's just the guards escorting you as you guys go like around a bend, down another avenue, and then there's like the turbo lift, which goes straight down to the prison shuttle level. Just up ahead, you guys can see it. The three guards, one of them is the captain, the three of you, and P9L, you're basically going to be put in here. You guys will be separated, and that's probably the last I'll see of you. What would your plan be?
Oh, shoot them with my Sidewinder and then take my ship and go
don't
find
have
my friend.
The Sidewinder.
I never let go of the Sidewinder. It's fused
then
to my
you
hands.
You don't have your hands.
You have hands.
Yeah. It was still functioning when I left.
Trying to open this door, damn it.
No. Okay, so you don't
have
hands.
Then, all right, then I use my heavy blaster carbine that's in my chest.
Okay, the thing that can pop out of your chest and shoot people.
Yeah.
That is fine, but you don't have hands then. Go on. Root. Or is this Talene?
I want my hands back.
But wait, I need my robot for robot things.
Well, his gun pops out of his chest, and Paul Lynch surely has a reaction to that.
Oh. Yahoo! Wait,
where are you gonna stick that, soldier?
Who's the guy with the confetti? Rip.
Oh. You're thinking of Rip Torn.
You're thinking of Rip Torn, buddy.
No, not Rip Torn. Rip Torn's got drunk and robbed a bank and was in charge of Men in Black.
Rip Taylor. Oh my god.
Taylor. Rip Taylor walks by as the gum pops out and throws some confetti, but you just keep passing on.
I think I have to turn in my, like, gay card.
See, if my robot had hands, he would have caught that gun that just fell to the floor.
Look, it just popped out.
He needs some hands.
Listen, I'm the only one who even knows Tamaya.
I know Tamaya.
I mean, but I worked for her for much longer.
I barely know her.
That's true. So your heavy blaster rifle.
No, well, they're gonna just put me in
the top of your chest.
Yeah.
Paul Lindria, or Captain Johnst, reacts with his gun out.
You're Paul.
The other two guys draw their guns.
What am I doing?
There you go. That's right.
What would you guys?
Oh boy. What you gonna do with that barrel, buddy?
Peanut, now come on.
Hey, just go. I'm not going to jail, man. I've been to jail. I was a gun, remember?
Well, then come with us and stop putting up a fight.
That's what I was trying to do, but they're trying to put me in the jail car.
Who locked me up? I'm ready to be cuffed.
All three of them jam their gun barrels into your chest and prepare to fire, which will just tear your chest.
All right,
chest.
I shoot all of them.
Okay. I go over there and I say, who wants to see me get poop done?
Oh, it's one of those nights. It's where everybody's crazy, and I'm.
Good night, everybody.
Video.
No, yeah, no, that's viral
I
video.
I feel so sad that this is what I've reduced root.
Oh man.
Oh no.
Well, listen, this is what happens when Gippy shows
up. Poland and the Harvey Fierstein cannot believe that they're getting this opportunity. Honey.
Oh boy.
All right, I book it. As soon as they look away.
Where are you running? Wait, so all you would... So, to clarify, and this is probably on my end. If you
looks like this guy's got the runs, but I'm staying put to watch this one.
Because the corridor, one way goes back to where our ship is.
Yes.
And one way goes
to a
prison
home. Okay, yes.
Yeah, you're fucking running for our ship.
Okay, great. That I'm fine with. They're at least distracted by that.
I yell the word yoink.
All three of them turn and start firing at you as you run.
Oh, well, then I shoot back.
Well, you'd have to stop running and turn around.
Yeah, no, yeah.
Wait.
I'm not a pussy.
What?
They shouldn't have shot at me.
Trump's America. All right, so.
No.
You guys, watch in horror.
I've done all I can do.
As P9L is shot over and over, one of the Harvey Fiersteins is just shot dead.
Oh no, that machinery that will be easily repaired.
Oh, right, yeah, he's not a person.
Yeah, just shot. We get a lot of.
He doesn't count! it's great!
Oh, wait, I have a jetpack. I don't even have to run.
Yeah, really?
We forgot about that as you're reaching for the button and then just one shot right through the chest.
They didn't even roll. That's some bullshit.
Well, we're short on time, and if I start rolling dice, we'll probably
You can't just say, threaten my life and then murder my character.
Drew is dead.
Do you want to kill both of them? You kill both Harvey Fiersteins, get shot dead.
No, I'm not happy unless they're all dead.
Well,
I mean, everybody.
Listen, as...
What?
Listen, as Root's agent, all I want to say is that this person does not represent me or my client.
Who are you speaking to, Poland?
I'm speaking to whoever's in charge.
Well, that's me, honey.
Yes, indeed. Listen, all I'm saying is like the New Republic. It's a nascent government entity, correct?
Go on.
It requires a certain level of, how do I say it, marketing. A certain level of propaganda.
Behind you, smoke coming out of the holes in the chest of P9L.
And if you really want the people on your side, you need something that not only edufies, but
you also... You better have a point here, honey, or I'm knocking you cold with the butt of my gun.
But also entertains. And I happen to represent the most entertaining act in the galaxy, which happens to be Root and her amazing Rancor poop. But
I do tricks. I have talent.
Where are you going with this?
All I'm saying, if you want the various rogue systems that are under old imperial governorships to join you, you may want something that sparkles, that has pizzazz. And the only way that you'll get through to that, which is her, is through me. And through me, my slave piece of machinery that you've disabled recently. I want that salvage in order to contract you with my services.
Oh, you're getting to the point. Yeah, that's no problem, baby. I can't do it.
I like how you speak to me. Random god, you have a way with words. Did you know that?
Did you know that?
I'm a captain. This is, anyway, all right, somebody grab this bucket of bolts and drag them down to the ship. Oh, we got places to go.
I like you, Maxi. Yes, yes, reassembling him and then make sure he's programmed to do my
As day. Soon as I'm online, he goes out the airlock.
That's fine. We'll resolve that when we play again next time. Instead, we screen wipe to them grabbing your arms, dragging you off into the interior of the Hertz.
Oh, you know what? That's too good for him. He's going to die slow. He's going to die slow and bad.
Did the Hertz get repaired? Did it get fixed up? Was that what you guys put your money into?
No.
Okay.
So the Hertz, that was it.
No, it's a dump.
The Hertz is still kind of a dump. Poland, not impressed by that. Can you voice Poland for me in his appearance?
I think you got it.
Poland. Yeah. What? Yeah, boy. This looks like the interior of a bathhouse after like a decade of disrepair, you know what I'm saying? I guess you guys didn't live through the 80s.
you hear a faint voice over the intercom. You're like, it's only going to get worse for you now. You're inside me.
If I had a nickel for every time, a space credit for every time I heard that, I'd be a millionaire.
I go out the airlock.
I follow.
Oh shit, we killed God.
Fade to black. I think we wrap this one up pretty quickly here tonight.
Yeah, I think
so you guys
Data get, side.
It's a good place to abandon it.
You guys get into the ship, take off as the captain gets clearance for you down the hallway. Well, I'm happy to say we're going to find that traitor's Tamiya Leck and bring her to justice. Is he like, again, just like cocking that gun.
My old gun.
What?
Put it down. Put down gun. Relax.
Yeah, we're flying in a ship. Come on. Ship's rules. No guns.
No guns around my client.
As you say.
I didn't agree to that.
Put it down.
This whole thing, we're going to try to talk about this.
He sits down, puts up his legs. As you guys get, it looks like, can someone raise the Holonet channel? I think we're getting news of what's going on with the election.
Slave, bring up the Holonet channel.
The slave is destroyed.
You turn, he's still smoke coming out of his
I'll
body.
Do yeah. it.
The smoke has stopped. He's just laying there.
Good job, boss.
You guys go flying out as you guys take off. And the counselor. Find out the new leader of the new republic, the new chancellor.
This ought to be good.
It's down between Mumpo Mumpabis, the Waller's face man from Waller on 3.
Now he wins. Spoiler.
And Trumpu the Hutt.
Oh no.
Who shouldn't really be on the ballot.
Wait a minute, did I register too late? Why am I not on this docket?
Representing. And Gippy Bindu wins! President of the Galaxy! President of the Galaxy!
Now do you owe me $3 million, right?
What? They haven't announced anything. You're dreaming.
Because he mutters in his sleep as he's dozing off.
Look, he thinks he's running.
The Hutt representing the powerful Hutt coalition that has taken such a big portion of the... And the results are in. It is Trumpu the Hutt. Trumpu the Hutt is the new leader of the new republic. This is incredible, folks. And she's Trumpu sliming out the giant blonde false weave on his head.
My eyes turn on glowing red. I just carve a despair symbol into my chest.
The very same Trumpu the Hutt you guys encountered before when you were in Trumpu Palace, fighting for your lives.
Did we not kill him?
Yeah, you tore out his heart. But
I have the funny feeling everyone I care about is going to have their rights taken away.
Here's the thing. I'm now the ruler of the huge galaxy. It's such a huge pleasure. I'm so glad I'm going to be the best.
Red
I'm
going to
be
sky.
The smartest.
Come on, New Order.
It's all going to go my way. Everybody can relax. My first order is going to be repealing these silly casino laws and allowing Hutt casinos to have total power in a much wider area of influence.
Oh, come on!
These are some big
the
league
first
changes.
Thing really is casinos?
Is that even the power of...
What the shit?
Yeah, there's murmurs everywhere. I mean, I didn't expect him to really do all those things he was saying he would do. No, it's looking bad.
Commentary.
Yeah. Yeah. Star Wars.
All right, so now you shoot Paul in.
And this is how democracy dies, with applause. Sorry, that episode.
Shut up, Padme. Nobody likes you.
At that point, Root, your nose picks up a familiar scent.
Oh, no, is it bombs?
No.
No, it's Ranker shit. It's the only thing you can smell.
Oh, I'm sorry, did you say bombs with an S? Yes, it is. Guys, I thought bomb smell you pick up on. And you like start sniffing around and you see one, and it's like boop, boop, boop. And then we start pulling out, and there's the boop, 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 boop coming from numerous
bombs
quarters
everywhere.
Around the ship.
Don't say bombs.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry, I make that noise in my sleep. I'll stop.
Okay.
Oh shit, that's a bomb.
As you wake up, so Trump of the Hut on the monitor, the Hertz, filled with bombs, which are all rapidly ticking down.
This is a nightmare.
Yeah, it is bad. And I guess, coordinates that you guys are going to try and find to locate Tamiya on her down. So, I think that is as good of a place as I can possibly think of for this particular evening to wrap things up on.
Shit.
Wow.
That's a cliffhanger.
A little bit of a cliffhanger. So, we'll pick up again in 2 weeks. In 2 weeks, guys, in 2 weeks we will get back. We will see if you can disarm multiple bombs while dodging gunfire in a dogfight. Oops.
I've got some skills for it, clearly.
Yeah, that'll be
good. How sticky are these bombs?
Well, hey, we'll find out next week.
How easily are they negotiated with, is all I'm saying.
How much if I open the airlock?
We all get sucked out. Mm-hmm. Well, we'll have to figure out what happens with you. Let's everybody give a big goodbye, everybody. Thanks for tuning in. Bye.
Bye, everybody.
See you.